Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm checking in to the historic Brick Hotel in Newtown, Pennsylvania, where I meet an overbearing owner who has run her business into the ground.
No.
And what was once a proud landmark, are they bullet holes in the wall?
That's mold.
Is now suffering from neglect.
This place is disgusting.
The road ahead is not going to be easy for me.
I try to get through to the owner, who's totally oblivious.
Thirty miles north of Philadelphia lies the borough of Newtown, Pennsylvania, home to this historic brick hotel. Owner Varan Darquois, a former therapist, bought the property in 2006 with her son CJ, who serves as a silent partner in their business.
We bought the Brick Hotel because it was an investment opportunity. When we first purchased the place, we were told that it was going to be a sort of a hands-off. It'll run itself, you just have to watch it.
Of course, we had no idea, zero idea what this business is about.
I always said to my son, maybe this year we'll make a profit. Maybe this year we'll make a profit. And it never happened.
She used to be in family therapy, so patience comes with that job. And I've seen her have a short fuse where she wouldn't do that before we bought the place.
When I came here, it blew my mind away that you're still putting in money. So I cut out a lot of stuff here, and it really annoyed and irritated people, and they basically started the dislike Verinder plan.
It has been a bit of a dictatorship here with Verinder. You know, it's either her way or not her way.
No.
Verinder is a control freak. She is involved in everything. She will not release or relinquish control ever.
Here's the ball. You want me to put it in?
She's not a people person. She has no people skills. She just screams out demands, and she's very rude at times.
Paul, French onion on here now.
There is such a turnover with staff that I don't even know their names.
In 8 months, I've probably seen over 50 people go. Some people come in for one shift, and they listen to her for 5 minutes, and they roll right out the door.
I wish I had two clones of me, and believe me, this place would be hopping.
I feel that Brick might have become like the laughingstock of Newtown.
So the reputation around town is that, you know, no nonsense, they call me the crazy lady, which is fine to me. You know what, if I'm crazy because I'm trying to save the business, so be it.
I think we're at that point where this is really our last chance. If we don't figure something out, it's either sell it, get rid of it, because we can't sustain it.
Before I came to town, I heard the Brick Hotel had a high turnover rate, so I had my team reach out to former employees so I can get some information before checking in.
First of all, good morning.
Good morning.
I've never met such a large team of ex-employees.
Small showing.
This is a small showing?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
What, there's more?
There's hundreds.
I would say hundreds.
How much turnover is there with staff?
When I left, Verinder had been through almost 50 managers.
15?
50.
50 managers?
50.
And the biggest problem with the place is what?
Verinder. She's been cruel to people. I watched her, and she's mean, and she can be a bully, and I've seen her reduce people to tears.
Wow, that's terrible.
You know, there's so much neglect between not only the staff, her managers, but her customers as well.
Seriously.
I couldn't take it anymore. I worked the holiday season, and it was kind of like the last straw for me.
And what made you quit?
I worked all of those parties through the whole month of December. I was lucky to receive some payback, like in February.
With your tips?
Yeah, she'll cut you a check in 6 weeks when she feels like it. She wouldn't let you go pick up your paycheck. She'd call the cops on you.
You said she called the cops on you.
Oh, all the time.
Numerous times.
Seriously, called the police because you wanted your money?
Yes. You're threatening her.
Yes. Seriously? I mean, it sounds like a dictatorship as opposed to a boss that's there to support.
People loved it there. It was very homey, the opposite of now. All the locals came. We had a booming hotel business.
Wow.
It was such a great place, and then the quality just steadily went downhill, and I think she had a complete lack of respect for the staff and didn't understand that your staff is a huge asset.
What a mess.
Can I ask you a question?
Please.
Have you met her?
Oh, no, at least I just arrived. Seriously, flew into Philly this morning.
You are in for a treat. I was curious, just by the way you were speaking, because I thought, he hasn't met her yet, has he?
No. So, calling the cops, you know, high staff turnover, standards dropping. I haven't got much confidence. However, I'm going to tackle it head on. You don't look very optimistic, do you? Thank you.
Well,
wish me luck. Thank you. Take care. Wow, look at the size of this place. Oh dear. What happened there? Damn. When did that happen?
You know, it's been here since I've been here.
Oh, really?
Hi, I'm Marianne. This place is here too.
Welcome. Likewise, good to see you. I get a bit nervous when I check into a hotel and the windows are smashed. Anyway, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
I'm happy to be here. Are they bullet holes in the wall?
You know, they might very well be. I'm not sure what they are. We're 250 years old, so.
250 years old?
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with the place?
I think it's a beautiful place, but I think it really just needs some upgrading.
And which part's beautiful? Help me. Certainly not the entrance with the smashed windows.
Well, I think it could be beautiful.
Yes.
It's been neglected for a while.
What happened here?
Oh. Oh, my.
Damn.
Oh, my.
That looks much better. Wow. Oh. Dear, oh, dear.
I don't know. Brander's not going to be too happy.
You just ripped the wallpaper down. That was fantastic.
What time is the owner calling in?
She might be here. I can check.
I'd love to meet her.
Oh, he's bringing Verinder up.
Verinder.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Yeah, very well. A little nervous. Mm-hmm. The smashed glass, what happened there?
It's been there since before I bought it.
Yeah, how long have you had the hotel?
10 years.
10 years?
Yeah.
And you didn't think about replacing it? First impressions, customers walking through the door?
It's the original.
Have you been drinking?
You look like I drink.
Did you run a hotel before you bought this 10 years ago?
Yeah. Never.
No?
Never.
No, what did you do?
Therapist for children. I did that for 20 years, that was my practice.
Wow. Okay, 201. I'll see you shortly. I'm gonna go check in and unpack.
Okay.
Place is filthy. What in the... Marianne? I need a rag, napkin,
okay.
Or housekeeping, please. God.
Oh, my.
What?
Let me get housekeeping for you.
Housekeeping? Call Fire Brigade.
Hello.
Are you the housekeeper?
I'm not. I'm looking for. I'm Caitlin.
Caitlin, please meet you. So my hands are dirty, so I'm just going to shake hands like that.
Excuse me.
I don't
yes.
want to shake hands like that.
Sure, no.
When was the last time this place was cleaned? There's dust and everywhere.
Talay is here every day, so I would assume.
Right.
Cleaning.
I mean, under here, look, I'm not talking about a couple of weeks of dust. I'm talking years. And behind here as well, look.
Hi, Talaya.
Hi.
Oh, jeez, how are you?
Oh, hi.
Are you good?
Yes, I'm fine.
Fine, right, yes. What do you do?
Housekeeping.
Stop. Which house?
This house.
Come over. Look at the mess down there.
What's that?
Fabuloso. Let's get the place clean, fabulous. Let's just have a little test here. Look at that. Look at that. Do you have a program that you clean floor by floor?
A program? No.
No. Where is my room to... What is that?
Is...
Now, what's that up there? Who sits here?
Aesthetics?
Is it a tea party for rats or Stuart Little in for dinner tonight? What the is that?
Oh.
What is it, like pet corner? We drop our cats off for dinner here? Man, who does this? You care to join me? Come on.
Go for it.
Come on. Let's sit at the veranda. Let's talk about your cleaning habits.
I don't think I can fit right there.
No, my butt's way bigger than yours. So take a seat. May we have some menus, please?
Oh, sure.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So what in the is going on?
I actually said something about that, but, you know.
You comfy?
Absolutely not.
No. All jokes apart, forget the mice party, tea party, Stuart Little hangout. What is the biggest problems here? Because I'm
things
not...
like this, the mold, the...
The mold? Whoa, whoa, whoa. We got rid of the dust. What do you mean the mold? Where's the mold?
Oh, right here.
Take me to the mold.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Excellent.
Let's start this way.
Right, where?
Let's go this way.
We'll go up first. Mold.
I guess it starts, I don't know exactly where it comes, but it comes from somewhere on the shower curtains. I asked her, can we change it?
There is mold. Do you tell the owner to change these out?
Yes, sir.
And any response?
She'll get to it.
Oh, look at this. Look at that. Come over.
Is that mold?
That is mold.
Yes, I said that.
That's mold. See it?
Mm-hmm.
Bloody hell. When was all the linen last changed? Look at the color of this. How much sweat is on there?
Oh, look. Man. Oh.
Look at the color of that.
So that's what that is, sweat?
That's sweat. And then, is that a tube television? How old? Have you ever heard of a flat screen?
Yeah, I got five.
You've got five flat screens?
At my house.
What a mess. What's that in there? What? A empty box of tights? Silk Perfections. Does the owner ever come into these rooms?
Since I've been here, I've probably seen her here maybe once.
Once upon a time, these were white, right? You see these? Look at the color of them. How gray and dirty. God, they stink.
Oh, you can tell. They're supposed to have been white.
I was worried about your eyes for a second there. Where's my room, please?
201.
Please tell me it's not worse than this one. 201. Bloody hell. What a mess. Dust everywhere. And all this, what is this? Terrible.
Girl.
How you doing?
You found all the nasty. No.
Oh, no.
I thought that the curtains were gold. No, for real. They were supposed to be white.
Oh, my goodness.
I am appalled.
And then just underneath it all, right now, it's pretty obvious that the owner doesn't even put a cent back into this room, even into the hotel. But when an owner can't be bothered to change a smashed window in reception, I don't hold much hope for the rest of the hotel. And look at that up there. What's that? Checkout time, 11 a.m. Yeah, I'll check out way before that, my love.
Hi. Nice to meet you. I'm Tammy.
Gordon. Good to see you.
Good to meet you.
And you're...
Sales and event coordinator at The Brick.
Rumors has it you do a lot of events.
Do a lot of events.
Wow. How many a week on average?
About 350 a year.
It sounds like this is the oxygen that's keeping this place alive.
Unfortunately, that's the truth.
Wow. What other problems are there? Help me.
Staffing is terrible.
Why are there so many staff going through the door? What is it?
Orvrandar is firing them. Often I'll come in on Monday and see who didn't make it through the weekend. She's very tough to work for.
The bottom line is, the problem is the owner.
Yes, there's nobody else here. Starts at the top.
I appreciate your honesty.
Well, we appreciate you being here.
After learning the hotel's revenue is strictly from events, I want to see how bad the food really is.
Seasonal, local, fresh. Mm.
I ordered a couple of items. The French onion soup, which was tasteless.
That's so bad. Terrible.
So I opted for something with a little more flavor.
Mmm, that tastes better. Mm.
Then I ordered something I've never heard of before, a cauliflower steak, which by name I should have known better.
That is a mess. Who put it on the menu?
Verinda.
And a crab sandwich, which maybe I would expect to be frozen, but not from a can.
Product of China. Fresh.
Mm-mm.
Seriously, are we done? Is there a,
You've got your burger still.
Do you know what? Cancel it.
Absolutely.
Because if it's coming from the same kitchen, forget it.
Got it.
Yeah, tell the chef I travel light and I haven't got that many pairs of knickers. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. He's freaking out. He's freaking out. Cancel everything else. No more. No more. He's had enough.
Take me to the kitchen. Introduce me to the team. Place is huge. Kitchen is massive. So where's the chef?
Hello? Monsieur?
I'm not the chef.
You're not the chef.
How you doing? Nice to meet
you. You are a chef, though. You got a jacket on.
Yes, sir.
That's how chefs tend to dress.
Yes.
Maceo.
Nice to meet
you. Likewise, good to meet you, too. And this
Barry?
Is...
Barry Sexton.
Barry. So
you got it.
You're the chef.
I'm not the chef.
No, you're the chef.
A chef, but not the chef.
A chef.
There's two of them.
There's two of them.
The other one's...
But where's the head chef?
Well, we have both of them in charge.
No such thing. Your set of rules, your set of rules. Doesn't benefit the customers. I'll come back to the food in a minute. I'm in shock. Before I got here, I met a dozen of your ex-employees.
Okay.
I couldn't believe the amount of staff that have left this building in the last 2 years. Why are you going through so many staff?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I think I hire people and...
Oh, so it's them, not good enough for you?
Yes.
When you have a young member of staff that is owed money and they won't leave the building until you pay them and you call the police on them, what kind of business are you running here?
Who said that?
Are you saying now that they're lying? Please.
I don't know.
Are you saying they're lying? Simple, yes or no?
I cannot tell people
you cannot
they're
tell.
Lying. It's inaccurate, though. I do.
Is it accurate?
Yes.
I have witnessed Verinder call the cops on a number of people. She has a close relationship with the Newtown Police Department.
Do you care about this hotel? It's not funny. I mean, I am not here to laugh. Let's get that right. Let's move on to my reception when I walked in and there's dust and everywhere. When I say dust, I'm talking dust that's been embedded for years. And there's mold on the carpet. I'm a little bit lost for words. I ever sat down in the restaurant and had dinner?
No.
Right. Top of your menu, it's fresh, seasonal, local. It's canned food.
I'm not a chef and I don't know all these things.
What's wrong? You feeling sick?
No, I need to take something out of the oven, chef.
You take it out of the oven. What is this? Tomorrow's chicken? Mm-hmm. I see you laugh. What is this? Again? You have to wake up.
Hi.
Hey guys, how are you?
Excited?
Yes,
for checking in.
No problem. Bye bye.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, how are you? Nice to meet you.
First name is?
I'm Jessica.
Jessica, good to see you.
I heard you had a great time today.
Great time, not, but yeah, let's wait and see. Who's that?
That is CJ. That is Verinder's son.
Oh,
hi.
CJ.
Yes, I'm one of the co-owners as well.
Good to meet you. How many times a week are you here?
I'm here right now probably less than once a month even. Right. I've got another job that I pretty much a full-time.
What'd you do?
Manage IT.
IT, wow. Why did you buy this?
Why did we buy this? It was an investment opportunity when we first got into it. We're told that it was turnkey, hands off.
So that was 10 years ago?
Yes.
Have you seen any return on that yet?
Zero.
Zero. When do you think it's coming?
Well, I have been talking about that quite a bit over the last 6 months because it's getting difficult to keep putting money in.
Wow. In your mind, forget him. What's wrong with the place?
I'm very sorry because I know this is your mom, but
it's
I can't I can't deal with how she treats me. It's like when we don't need her here, she's here and she's on me about the smallest things.
Wow. Do you have one foot in their camp or one foot in your mother's camp?
I'm split between the two. I've actually had employees tell me, why aren't you around more, because you're pleasant to deal with.
How's this gonna get turned around if she's still micromanaging and dictating to everybody about how this place should be run?
She says if she's not here, it's things will fall apart and it won't get done.
That sounds right.
Anyway, here's the customers.
Hi guys, how are you?
Good evening.
Good, how are you?
Welcome, how are you? You well?
You guys have a reservation?
Yeah, Weinstein.
Sorry about the smash window. And the crowd's from China.
Crowd's from China.
Okay, you guys can follow me.
No, I don't go to China for crap.
Gentlemen, I have one order for you. It's just the first course on the first table. It's just two soup of the days. Thank you.
Okay, who's next?
I got all the soups, all right?
Yep. First thing is this. It's apple pear noble blue cheese and an eggplant stack. Where's the apple pear? Can we get this out?
Why is she doing this? Is she always on the hot plate?
She is. She's never quiet.
Which ones are done? Can you guys take those down? Is this done?
No, I've taken my stuff down that's done.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a little aggravating.
Guys, waiting on the eggplant.
It's coming, Verinda. It's coming. We're working it hard. You're making us nervous.
Oh, my goodness. Carly. Carly?
What? I'm coming. What is that?
Put this here. Take this. This is yours.
No, that is my New York
strip.
No, it's not. This is craziness.
Who's doing the cauliflower?
Are you cooking the cauliflower now?
Yes.
Nuts.
I know.
I swear to God.
Mason, can you flip this?
And what's she doing cooking?
I have no idea.
Does she normally cook?
Yeah.
This is crazy. Absolute crazy. What a mess. Wheels are stuck. It's just sliding on the grease. Oh, God. That is gross. Miranda, you got 2 seconds?
Sure.
Just stand behind there, will you?
Oh, my goodness.
Just, no, please stand behind there. I'm...
What is this? Maceo, you guys just cleaned this. Is this from today?
I don't even know what's back there, Verinder.
What? When was that cleaned?
They just cleaned it 2 days ago. They got spilled everything there.
Come here. I know, hand on heart, that is not from yesterday. That is not from yesterday. What's that up there?
Seriously?
Watch your eyes, watch your eyes. Who cleans it? Who is it?
Since I've been here, no one's cleaned it.
Since you've been here?
No one's cleaned it.
I appreciate your honesty. Miranda.
Yeah.
Since he's been here, he's never cleaned it. This place is disgusting. And this?
Well, Gordon, I don't come and do this.
You don't want?
I trust them that they would clean where they're... You guys cleaned the floor the other day, didn't you?
We cleaned the line the other day. We sweeped the line.
You said you guys took out...
No, I never said that.
Stop. You're just trying to make excuses. Yes, you are. Aren't you embarrassed?
Very.
At least you told the truth. The owner's in denial. That has been pulled out for months.
That wasn't pulled out.
What a mess.
What is this?
Bloody hell. Holy crap.
Don't put it there.
Oh my gosh. What in the is that? Oh my gosh. What in the is that?
That's grease from the hood.
Can you stop lying? That was not cleaned yesterday.
I'm telling you, this is grease from the hood, but they haven't cleaned it.
Do you have any idea what happened if that caught fire?
I don't know.
Now, do you have any idea if that caught fire?
I do.
What are you doing? You stopped caring.
No, that's not true. I mean, I...
That's a sign of an owner that cares. I want an answer. I'm going upstairs. By the time I come down, I want an answer. CJ, is he gone?
I don't know where he went.
Oh, my God. Right. I'm unconvinced that this place is clean. So, I want to run a quick bacteria test.
It looks disgusting. And I don't think these vents have been cleaned for years.
Time will tell.
Did you talk to Ramsay?
No.
He came down here looking for you.
There she goes. Now, 10 to 20 is deemed as sort of clean, respectable. Anything over 30 is unhygienic, dangerous, and this is reading. 573. Come in.
You were looking for me?
Sit down.
What is that?
This is a very simple hygiene test. Anything above 30 is in the danger zone.
Okay.
573 from the air conditioning unit.
I don't have an answer for that, sorry. That's...
CJ, yeah. 573. Let's do another one. How long's this chair been here?
I believe since we bought the place.
Have you seen the stains on it? See the stains there?
Yeah.
Let's see what that says. Do you ever stay here?
No, I've never stayed here.
You've never stayed here in 10 years?
No.
Wow, so you bought a hotel, you invested in it with Mum, and you've never stayed here. I'm amazed. 446. And you've got no idea it's like this. What's the bathrooms like? Oh, my God. Do you know the shower curtains have got mould on them?
No, I did not.
Your housekeeper pointed it out. There's hairs there. At this rate, I really should be wearing gloves. Oh, dear. A shower curtain. What? 5,680. What in the... Seriously?
I don't have an answer for that at all.
5,680. That is the volume of live bacteria. I'm gonna wash my hands now. 5,000. What in the hell's going on? I'm gonna go and just check. 301. Sorry, Disturby. Are you well? I'm so sorry. Do you mind? Listen, we've got some issues downstairs and found some pretty horrific stuff. I know you're getting ready for bed. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I honestly didn't think they were going to put anyone in here today. I'm all right. Look, inside.
What is it?
That's mold underneath.
No, you did not. No, you did not, really.
That is disgusting. And I did a bacteria test. I've been doing them all day. On my shower curtain was mold.
I just took part.
Will you just give me 2 minutes, okay?
Oh my God.
What a joke. This is insane. I'm done. Let's go, come on, let's go.
Oh no. Oh my God.
Leave your bags there. Make your way down to the front, please. Leave the phone, it's not important. Customers are way more important. Leave the phone. Customers out. Customers out. Let's go. Out.
Barry, drop what you're doing. Go off the premise, please. We're not going to be serving this anyway.
Quick, let's go. We've got to move. Fast on that. Let's go. Everybody stand at the front. Just wait 2 seconds.
Is everyone out? This isn't a drill.
Oh, my God.
First of all, I just want to apologize. There's no fire. More importantly, over the last 3 hours, all I've done is a bacteria test.
No!
I want to apologize to all of you, but I want to stop right now while I try endlessly to get through to the owner, who's totally oblivious.
Is that the owner?
This is the owner.
We all ate here, we were all planning on staying here, and you're smiling like a smirk on your face.
What I'm not gonna do is just allow this lady to laugh at me, you guys to pay good money and eat, and I'm certainly not letting paying guests stay to sleep here. I'm done. My team will assist you getting yourself out of there. Relax, there is no fire, but we are not gonna continue. I wanna stop right now and shut this place down.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I'm so sorry. I need you now. Thank you. When are you gonna get real? When are you gonna stop, close the door, and take a good look at yourself in the mirror?
If I say anything, it's not believed, so what's the point?
What do you mean it's not believed? What is wrong with you?
But I can...
What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you?
There's nothing wrong with me. It's just after 10 years, I'm here every single day. They don't like me, and they insult me, and they disrespect me every second they work here. They steal from me. They're on their cell phones for 4 hours a day.
You're disrespecting every member of staff. You're blaming everybody for what you've created. Somewhere you switched off and ignored all the problems and took it out on the staff.
That's what they're telling you.
Yes, that's what they're telling me. Right now, I'm going to tell you something you've never heard before. You're out of your depth.
Last night, after shutting down the hotel and seeing Varandar had no communication with employees, I organized a staff meeting.
Anyone down there?
But Varandar was nowhere to be found.
There you are, they've been looking for you. They said that you'd run away.
No, I'm not running away. I don't know why you're running
down. You don't want to be in front of the staff. Why not? My biggest problem is that you have shut down and you refuse to let anybody in.
I walk through the windows, people steal from me every single day.
And so you had some incidents with some bad staff years ago, and then you think everybody that comes through your door is exactly the same. No, they're not. It's not about a one-on-one anymore. You can't just focus on one individual. And you've done that brilliantly in the previous career. Running a team, managing a hotel is completely different.
All right, okay.
We need to get the team back on side, and they need to believe in you, and you need to believe in them. It's a two-way thing.
Well, it's a process too.
It is a process.
Yeah.
But if you don't walk back through those doors and face the music with me, then I'm gonna go as well, because I can't do this without you.
I don't know how.
Let me show you how. Well, first of all, thanks for coming in early this morning. Listen, this is hard. There seems to be a massive conflict. How do we get the trust back in the room? What would you like to see change?
We just did a funeral last week, 90 people, and there was 2 servers. 0 busers, 0 bartender.
Well, of course it's a money issue, it's a budget issue. So I took it over, and that is why.
We had a schedule on Monday for the cooks. We come back Tuesday, the schedule's completely changed.
You do the schedule? But this should be the chef's job.
Absolutely.
You need to be responsible for your own departments. I mean, like Macy's responsible for the kitchen, Tammy's responsible for the events. You have to offload the work from you and give them the responsibility.
I guess that's a mistake.
When was the last time you all had a meeting?
We had a service staff meeting in here that we get yelled at, and it just gets hostile, and people get up, and me included, and walk out, and it just doesn't help anything.
Let's stop there. We're not. It's not
but
a
this
complaint.
Is why, this is why no one wants to. No one ever
if,
says
if you
anything
want a manager,
because you can't get
Mike,
your voice out.
Wait a minute.
But you must understand now. That's the wrong way to handle things. There seems to be a really bad vibe in the room that we can't shake off.
But if you want to clear the air, people need to turn their phones off when they walk in and clock in.
Can I say something about the phones?
I have said that a million times. Please do not bring your cell phones in here. And invariably, I come in at 2 o'clock. I see you guys outside on your cell phones. That is a break.
Never see me on my cell phone outside.
You know, okay, fine. I mean, you know, maybe you're not doing it, but other people are doing it.
Why is there so much distrust in this building?
It's people stealing from me, drinking on the job, doing shots over here.
That's not now. We're talking as if it's present.
It's not happening today, yes, but there is, I mean, you know.
These guys aren't taking shots. But what I'm trying to say, you're accusing them of somebody else's bad practices. What you need to stop doing is blaming them for the past. Can you trust your team?
Yes.
Tell them that.
Okay, I'll try.
Please.
But I can promise.
Well,
I can only try.
Look at that smile. That'll go a long way. We all know it's not going to change overnight.
It's a process.
So we need to embrace that process and we need to install confidence.
I'm open to the change that he wants me to follow. If that's what's going to make this place a success.
I feel like the staff meeting was a step in the right direction. Veranda seems to be coming around, but I want to make sure she is 100% committed.
Morning. Thanks so much for coming.
I really need to talk to CJ privately, because he's the one person who can help get through to her.
CJ, I'm going to be honest, I'm going to be up front. I'm not dealing with a hotelier. I'm dealing with your mum. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure she holds a special place in your heart, but unfortunately she's running around like a dictator and she's not letting any of the staff breathe. She's stifling the business.
I've had conversations with her about a few things similarly. I've told her the way we were brought up and raised in India, that tone and conversation doesn't work here. And she struggled, to be very honest, adapting to that part of it.
You adapted brilliantly come to this country, but she's one tough cookie. Yes. You know that.
Yeah.
She is nitpicking the staff, and then she's not giving any of them responsibility. She needs to be less hands-on.
Okay.
And more supportive.
No, I know. I know.
This is crazy. Mid-60s, she shouldn't be running around like this.
No. She was very honest with me last week. She told me, I want to spend more time with the kids and my time is running out. And I haven't heard her say that ever.
Right. But she needs to let go.
Okay. So how can I help?
I need a commitment from you. You've got to be there to support her. We need to get rid of that stubbornness from your mum and make her understand that this business can be fruitful. She just has to step back.
Okay.
We can't continue like this. It's do or die, and we need to step up.
Okay. All right. I'm going to have a talk with her today.
Please. We got one more shot at this.
After spending time with CJ, he clearly sees the issues his mother has, and I have asked him to reinforce the changes she needs to make.
What we should talk about is how do you let go? The responsibility is shifting, which means you don't run around doing things. If it's Maceo's kitchen, if you're making that decision, it's not your problem to deal with. Let Tammy and the kitchen chef do everything. I had learned it the hard way at my job. I was working 70 hours a week, mother.
Yeah.
But when I got the team in place and I stepped away, I only get involved when there's an escalation.
Okay. All right. I mean, you know, I can do that.
And you know what? Let's see what happens.
With Veranda on the right track, the next order of business is starting the renovation process. The Brick Hotel needed drastic changes, so my team worked through the night to get the hotel ready for relaunch.
Welcome to the new Brick Inn.
Wow.
Oh.
What?
Oh
my God.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Yeah. It's beautiful.
Oh my goodness.
It's amazing.
It is.
Would you like to come up and see my room?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
I'm about to take a nap. I'm taking a nap. I think I might have to come check it out. Oh no.
Every
everything about these rooms are amazing.
Wow.
I'm excited to come to work and clean.
Go on, Vanda, jump on that.
Go ahead.
Go on, jump down.
Oh my goodness.
If you don't do it, I'll do it.
Oh my goodness. Very nice. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
Yeah.
After updating the Brick Hotel with a modern look, I give them a classic menu that is perfect for the town and can better accommodate catering for the large-scale events that take place at the hotel.
Hi, good evening. Welcome to the Brick Hotel.
As for the relaunch, I invited the locals not only to dine at the Brick.
How are the first couple bites of everything? Oh, fantastic.
They're the best golfs I've ever actually had in my life.
But to tour the renovated rooms as well.
Look at this.
Wow.
Oh my God. Look how nice this is. Ah.
While on the hotel side, everything has been well received. The kitchen is running smoother than ever.
Meatballs, arancini, sprouts,
Japanese.
Yes, one at a time.
86 Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, 86 Brussels sprouts, please.
86 Brussels sprouts.
That's a good sign. Thank you.
And with CJ having a presence.
Right, Brussels sprouts.
Nice. Should I go get them?
No, what do you mean, go get them?
He's able to prevent his mother from slipping back into her old habits.
It's okay. Let it go. You said it's a good sign.
It's a good sign.
Yeah.
Now she can focus on her duties as an owner.
It looks fantastic.
Yeah, it looks great. Yeah,
well,
looks
thank really you.
Great
thank
job. You. Customers are happy?
Yes.
Yes.
First of all, it's so nice to see you smile.
Yes.
She had to walk around this town with your head up high.
Well, I apologize for the difficulty I gave you initially.
Okay, and the only thing I want to see you do is, from time to time, come in here and walk around, like you did all night tonight, with charm and grace. I've told them that you are banned from behind that line. Okay, good.
All right, I promise you all this stuff will happen.
Promise me.
Yes.
Pinky promise.
Pinky promise. I'm not a person who expresses joy or in a jumping up and down and things like that. But it's really, really wonderful. It's given us a lot of oxygen for a second life.
Best wishes. Take care. Thank you. Wow, what a week.
After leaving the Brick, the reputation of the hotel was on the mend. CJ became a more visible owner, and Veranda stayed true to her word, entrusting her staff to do their jobs. And her employee turnover is at an all-time low. With these changes in place, the Brick is well on its way to being what it once was. I'm checking into a family-run lodge in Island Park, Idaho, where business has taken a toll on a married couple that has lost their way.
We've had a lot of hard years and a lot of arguing. I know we're in trouble.
My struggle is not only to fix the lodge.
That's 15 years of dust. Like the dog sat on it.
Is that blood?
But to renew the passion that they once had.
The heart's gone. We need to get that back. It's about to collapse.
One potato, two potato.